Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. There is a famous hadith in Bukhari in Kitab al-Ilm that once Sayyidina Musa alayhi salatu wasalam was delivering a talk and a sermon when a person from the congregation asked him a pertinent question. Man a'lamu an-nasi? O Musa, who is the most learned person? Musa alayhi salam replied, Ana, I am the most learned person. Fa'atab Allahu ala Musa. Allah then reproached and chastised Musa alayhi salam. إِذْ لَمْ يَرُدَّ الْعِلْمَ إِلَيْهِ, simply because he did not direct knowledge to the Almighty. Then Allah sent wahi to Musa alayhi salam that there is a servant of mine at the confluence of the two seas, at the junction of the two oceans, أَعْلَمُ مِنْكَ, he is more learned than you. Of course, the narrative continues that Musa alayhi salam embarked on the sacred journey to meet this individual. In Bayanul Quran, it is written the wisdom why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted Musa alayhi salam to travel on this journey and meet this individual, لِتَعْلِيمِ الْإِحْتِيَاطِ فِي الْكَلَامِ, to impress upon Musa alayhi salam the importance of exercising caution in speech. Pause for a moment, my brother, and reflect for a moment, my sister. Musa alayhi salam was the most learned. He was a Nabi. He was from amongst the Ulul Azm. Academically, his reply was correct. He was the most learned. But Allah disliked it because he did not attribute it to the Almighty. You and I are devoid of knowledge, bereft of wisdom. If we're going to claim knowledge, can you imagine how disliked this will be in the eyes of Allah? In Madarij al-Salikin, it is written that when a servant says, I have observed fast, I have given charity, I have gone for Hajj, Allah says, my servant, but I gave you the ability, I gave you the strength, I gave you the might. And yet when a servant says, oh my Lord, I thank you for allowing me to fast, I thank you for allowing me to recite Quran, then Allah says, oh my servant, it is your sincerity, it is your passion as well. So what's the message? We need to harness our tongue and we need to exercise caution and never pontify ourselves. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen.